Now, I told yous, I'll fucking play you this shit, right? Scorpions. It was all about the fucking King Scorpion. Yeah, the Pharaoh. The first Pharaoh was a Scorpio. The Scorpion King was the first Pharaoh. That's where you get the fucking movie from and everything. We'll go into all that. I already have, obviously, in past videos. But you want to see this? Oh, I fucking told you. I'll show you it.
But for the first time in the history of the planet, those who were in shorelines down there were alive with animal activity. This may not have been a good time to take the kids to the beach. Armies of sea scorpions were messing in the shallows. Known to paleontologists as Eurypterids, some of these intimidating arthropods grew as long as a man is tall, and they bristled with armored legs and fearsome claws.
Yeah, oh, the scorpions, and what were they? What were these scorpions, really? Huh? Let's see, why don't we go here for a minute?
A descent into Murchison Gorge takes you back to those ancient Silurian shorelines. Down here, it soon becomes clear that the sea scorpions followed Calbaria ashore.
This is what we call Track Central.
I can see why.
Yeah,
there are tracks everywhere.
This is probably the best site in the park to look at these Eurypteran tracks. Our animals come through here.
So in shallow water?
Shallow water.
Okay, been slipping and sliding a little bit as they come around the corner.
That's exactly right.
But here, I mean, I can see clearly this is kind of sloppy looking track here.
It is.
But once you come over here, you start seeing really discreet footprints. Clear graphic demonstration of...
Yeah, of what? Scorpion tracks coming out of the sea. Yeah, the first fucking land fucking dweller that came out of the sea was a scorpion. You know, yeah, a scorpion.
Of a creature walking out of the water and onto dry land.
Oh, wow.
Well. Here we are here in the depth of the gorge. We're in the oldest of the Silurian sediments in this area.
Oh, a historic little spot you've got here.
Very, very.
These trackways offer some of the oldest evidence for animals on land. And even though these formidable beasts could not stray far from the water's edge, a beachhead had been established.
So this seems to be how the animal invasion of the land began, with a scary assortment of arthropods with attitude slinking and scuttling ashore onto the wet sands of a new frontier.
Well, what do you know?
There wasn't just a continent to exploit. There was a whole planet for the taking.
Yes. A whole planet for the taking. Yeah, so what do you know, huh? Eh? I tell you the truth, don't I? I always tell you the truth. Why don't we go King Scorpion, huh? Just whack that in there. King Scorpion. I mean, do you believe in coincidences? All of this shit. You believe in coincidences? I don't believe in coincidences, no. Well, what do you know? King Nama. King Nama. Hmm? Oh, the Scorpion King and the birth of Egypt. It's all about the scorpion. Is that a coincidence? Is it a coincidence? Yeah, that was the Scorpion King was the first pharaoh? Hmm? Before the pharaohs? You know? And fucking, yeah, the pharaohs came after the scorpion and all life came after the scorpion. It's all about the fucking scorpion. You fucking look into all this shit, it's always about the scorpion. It's all about Scorpio. And King Pharaoh, fucking Scorpio, is what it's all about. I mean, the Scorpius. And what are you pious? Scorpio. Pio means pious. Yeah, what are you pious? Oh, well, that's right. They're fucking all those stupid people in the Vatican think they're pretty pious, don't they? And instead they fucking brainwash you with stupid shit like the Scorpion King movie. Oh, yeah. Right, you're fucking gonna know something. Right, you're just stupid. Absolute morons. Don't fucking realise what's staring at your face, because you get told how fucking, you know, the scorpion's unlucky. Unlucky Scorpio. Oh, the scorpion's evil and all this shit. And you get told 13's unlucky. And the unlucky 13 and 13's evil and all that shit too. Just like 666. Well, you're told that's unlucky and fucking evil and all this fucking shit too. But you don't look there, do you? That's what the whole point of them fucking brainwashing you into not looking in these places, isn't it? So, is the scorpion unlucky? Is 13 unlucky? Jesus Christ was the 13th because he had 12 apostles. So is Jesus Christ unlucky and evil? Is he? Or is Jesus Christ a scorpion? Well, 666. Is that evil? Or is it, you know, life? Life. Just like you fucking get told over and over and over again, but they don't want you to believe that life's evil because they want you to go out there and live and fucking live great in your minds of fucking living, thinking you're not slaves, but you're actually fucking slaves. But if you hated life and you loved and looked for the fucking, you know, what was after life more than you fucking did in the life, in the here and now, then they wouldn't be their ways now, would they? But back in, Egypt, it was all about the afterlife, wasn't it? It was all about fucking what was after death was more important than what was fucking in life. And life, we were just here to be fucking whatever. And we all had to look forward to what was after death. So they can't have people doing that, can they? Nah, no. They need people to love and worship life. Shall we go to, let's see, Bible Hub. No, charges, wanting to be sleeping, you are, you can go to sleep, can't you? You're sleeping there. Oh, Bible Hub. Why don't we chuck in, say, Jeremiah 51. Jeremiah 51:63. Bible Hub, Jeremiah 51:63-64. What is this all about then, eh? Now it shall be when you have finished reading this book that you shall tie a stone to it and throw it out into the Euphrates. To the Euphrates. A stone to it and throw it into the Euphrates. Why would you want to do that? And thou shalt say, thus shall Babylon sink, and shall not rise from the evil that I will bring upon her, and they shall be weary. Thus far are the words of Jeremiah. Well, what do you know? Babylon's going to sink by tying a stone to a book and throwing that book into the fucking Euphrates. Well, so the Euphrates would be like a sea, would it? And that stone would represent what? Some kind of bigger stone we're talking about here? Because it's all about Apophis. All right. Apophis. And who is Apophis? Apophis, this fucking asteroid. 99942. Apophis. And when's Apophis coming? April the 13th, 2029. So, let's see. Jesus Christ was, what, AD 30 or AD 33. So 2,000 years after AD 30, AD 33 would make it what? About 2030? So Jesus is meant to return in 2030. Thus says everyone, you know, ever fucking, you know, told you anything about fucking supposedly Jesus Christ's return. So Jesus Christ is meant to return around 2,000 years after AD 30, or fucking AD 33. So 2,000 years after AD 30 or AD 33 is what? Is what, huh? 2030 or 2033? Well, Apophis comes in 2029, and it will be seen in our heavens. And between 2029 and 2036, we'll all be fucking shitting ourselves, wondering if it's going to come back and fucking strike us in 36, 7 years after. So 2029, we're going to see it. We're going to see it in the fucking sky. Everyone's going to be talking about it. Everything that's going on now with Iran and all these wars and everything has fucking got nothing to do with anything. This is what it's all about. They're going to go on roars and rumors of wars until you see the coming of the Son of Man in the clouds. Yeah, right? The coming of the Son of Man in the clouds. And what's Apophis? Apophis is what? Apep. So we're Apophis, Apophis. Why don't we just go Apep, Apep. It's a flying serpent. Apep, right? Apep, spelled Apepi or Apep or Apophis. Apophis, ancient Greek, was the ancient Egyptian deity who embodied chaos and was thus opponent of light and mart, order and truth. He appears as art as a giant serpent, right? A giant serpent. So let's see. A serpent. Well, we heard serpents before. Have we heard of the great plumed serpent of Mexico? What's a plume? A plume. And the plumed serpent. What would a plumed serpent be? Like, what would you fucking expect a plumed serpent? Because last time I fucking watched, let's say a nuclear fucking bomb show, a nuclear cloud or mushroom cloud, right, was a what? A plume. So why don't we go nuclear, a plume. A nuclear plume. Oh, well, what do you know? A nuclear plume. So you know what a plumed serpent is? Would that be like the, shit going up to the plume of the fucking serpent, which would be the fucking body of the nuclear fucking mushroom cloud? Because you only think of it as mushroom clouds, but it's a nuclear plume. But, it's the plumed serpent. That's what it's all about, isn't it? Plumed serpent. Why would they, feathered serpent. Why would they fucking, call Apophis after Apep anyway? Are they not telling you something? It's all about a serpent. It's all about the good serpent and the bad serpent. So we've got a feathered serpent. What other feathered serpents do we have? We have the rainbow serpent. Huh? Yeah, we have the rainbow serpent in Australia. We have the, what? The nagas? Yeah? Well, the nagas, the rainbow serpent. We've got the plumed serpent. All these fucking countries that didn't have supposedly anything to do with each other, so we're told. Right? But they all fucking share this worship of serpents. Including what? Vikings and, dragons and shit? What about the fucking dragons in fucking what? Huh? China. Isn't there two dragons? Because there's two serpents. Yeah, there's two serpents. There's two dragons. There's a good dragon, there's the bad dragon. There's the good serpent, there's the bad serpent. So which is what? Or is it all yin and yang? All part and parcel of the same fucking thing? The good side and the fucking bad side, or the light and the darkness, or the truth, and the lies, or the good and the fucking evil. It's all fucking that, isn't it? Yin and fucking yang. So we've got fucking what? Friday the 13th. It's always meant to be a fucking what? Unlucky number. Oh, Friday the 13th meant to be an unlucky day. Because it's the 13th. But Jesus Christ was the 13th. And Jesus Christ is whom we're all waiting to come back, is he not? Is that who we're waiting for? Jesus fucking Christ to come back? Because, we've got the what? The lions in China. The same fucking thing as the dragons. And the same fucking thing as the fucking serpents. You got the good lion and you got the bad lion. You got the good dragon, you got the bad dragon. You got the good serpent, you got the fucking bad serpent. All right? And how can we, express that? Say, we've got an over King Scorpion. I mean, you can watch all this shit. I've covered it all before in fucking past videos and shit. Let's go and look this crap up. I mean, it's all fucking worthy of your attention. It's all what they don't want you to fucking know. I mean, what's the fucking serpent do? Does the serpent, take a bite, a swing at you? Just like a fucking, what? Huh? A scorpion? Isn't that what fucking dragons are supposed to do? And what would do that, you reckon? You reckon, a feathered serpent would be a flying serpent? Because a flying serpent would be flying through the sky? And isn't a serpent what everybody would have thought of as an asteroid coming in to hit the Earth? Is that why Apep is fucking Apophis? Yeah, and a plumed serpent would be like a nuclear fucking bomb going off. A perfect example would be fucking this. We're going to click on it. We got the serpent and the plume. And isn't that what fucking an asteroid would look like coming into our atmosphere? Rolling in like a scroll. Hmm? And we have Apep, who is the what? Order and truth. He's going to bring a new order because there wasn't any truth in the fucking world. You know, Apep, that ancient fucking serpent who flies through the sky as we fucking wait for Apophis. Yeah, Apophis, who is Apep in 2029. When Jesus Christ's return is meant to be around, what, 2033, huh? I mean, really, think of it. What's this all about? Is it like a warship? You know, warship would be worship. You worship something. It's all about the warship. Hmm? And it's all about the justice, isn't it? The justice. But what's left at the end of the age? Would it be just ice is left at the end of the fucking age? The absolute end of the age? Because there's two ages to be fulfilled. There's Apophis in 2036. And then after Apophis strikes and we rejuvenate and the meek inherit the earth. I mean, you could sit there and laugh at all of this shit. But, I mean, really, you're all told in science and shit that the dinosaurs died out from the same fucking thing. The same thing, an asteroid. Isn't that right? The dinosaurs. And the meek are supposed to inherit the earth. How do the meek inherit the earth? There has to be great destruction for the meek to inherit the earth. That's the only fucking way that the meek can inherit the earth. And what's going to help with the poles flipping and everything? I mean, wouldn't a fucking asteroid help with the poles flipping? If the poles flipped, you know, an asteroid, you'd fucking think, would fucking make a great deal of fucking, you know, damage to help out with the poles flipping. Isn't that fucking true? I mean, you'd be pretty stupid to think not, isn't it? So why would Apophis be named after Apep, a fucking god of Egypt that is a serpent? What has all these serpents got to do with anything? Jesus Christ was the serpent. And he fucking the serpent that Moses held up in the wilderness for everybody to get fucking healed from. Just as he says, as the Son of Man, you know, is lifted up. Because it's all about him being lifted up like the fucking serpent. Isn't that fucking true? Huh? So we've got all this fucking shit that points to a fucking serpent. A nuclear plume, a plumed serpent, a feathered serpent, a flying serpent. Yeah. See how interested Tashi is? She loves this. She's, oh, well, look at Tashi. Oh, you gotta go to bed. Oh, not, you're gonna scratch yourself instead. So, I mean, he's getting the point here. Hmm? Are you getting the point? And Jeremiah 5:1, 6:3-6:4. Is all about this coming, right? And thou shalt say, thus shall Babylon sink. Babylon shall sink. The world shall sink and shall not rise from the evil that I will bring upon her. Upon her. And they shall be weary. Thus far are the words of Jeremiah. All right? So, and what did he say before that? We go back. And it shall be when thou hast made an end of reading this book that thou shalt bind a stone to it and cast it into the midst of Euphrates. Okay, Euphrates. So let's see then, shall we? Isaiah 47:3. Oh, you should know it's raining here. It's raining and it's cold. It's like winter again. Yeah, the day, yesterday was fucking, what, when I went for that fucking walk. It's the 6th now. So it was yesterday I went for that fucking walk or whatever. Or was it, no, 4th or whatever. It was yesterday when I uploaded that fucking video, yesterday evening at fucking 1 o'clock or some shit. So yeah, it was yesterday, and it was fucking days of heat, and now it's fucking, what, the 6th, and it's raining. Thy nakedness shall be uncovered, yea, thy shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance, and I will not meet thee as a man. I will not meet thee as a man. This is Jesus Christ's second coming. Jesus Christ's second coming. And he will not meet thee as a man. And this is the fall of Babylon. Babylon. The fall of Babylon. So how is he going to meet people? How is Jesus Christ going to meet people if you're all waiting for Jesus Christ to come? Right? Thy nakedness shall be uncovered. Babylon's nakedness. The world's nakedness. Yea, thy shame shall be seen. The world's shame will be seen. And I will take vengeance. Because this is all about Jesus coming back to take vengeance. Because that's what he's coming back to do. Take fucking vengeance. It's all about east to west, remember? From east to fucking west. In the east he is born for you, fucking to die for your sins. In the west he comes back to remind you that you should have listened to him. And if you didn't listen to him, he's going to make you die for your sins. And then it repeats itself. You understand? Thy nakedness shall be uncovered, yea, thy shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance, and I will not meet thee as a man. So if he's not going to meet thee as a man, does that mean he's what? He's not going to fucking treat you like a man because he's coming to bring vengeance? Or does that mean he's coming as like a vicious beast and you're not going to see a man, you're going to see a vicious beast? Or does that mean he's coming as an angel and you're not going to see a man or a vicious beast, but you're going to see an angel? But would an angel come, and see it as an angel bringing vengeance? I will take vengeance. He will not be fucking met. You will not meet him as a man. He will not be met as a man. There's no man coming. There's only vengeance. God's vengeance coming. And you will see God's vengeance coming on the clouds. That's right, on the clouds and in heaven. As he fucking left, he shall come again. I mean, you could express the same friggin' thing with, when you see him, or when you see Apophis in 2029, you're going to know it's going to come again. It's going to be flying through the sky, and you're going to know that it's fucking got a very good chance it's going to strike the earth in 2036. And this is what all these wars and shit's going to fucking entail. It's going to fucking, all the wars and rumors of wars is going to come up to 2029, and the fucking Apophis is going to supposedly bring everyone together. It's a big fucking scam, people. And he's all going to be like fucking, oh, Iran, oh, this, oh, that, oh, fucking wank. This is why I'm not fucking fussed with all this shit anymore. Because just like Jesus says, be not afraid. Yeah? Wars and rumors of fucking wars. 2029, you're going to see Apophis, and they're fucking, it's going to be all over the news and shit. All right, it's going to be all over the news, and it's all going to be like, oh, is it going to strike us? Be ready to watch Apophis in the sky. Then they're going to prepare you. It might fucking strike us in 2036, 7 years later. Right? 7 years later, we might be all fucked, and we're going to have to do something about fucking Apophis because it could strike the earth and we're all doomed. And the whole world's going to come together to try to fucking fight the serpent. Try to fight the coming of the serpent. Because they're going to fucking want to prevent the serpent from destroying the earth. And if they can't, they're going to be hiding in crevices of the rocks, aren't they? They're going to be hiding from the fucking all this shit. I mean, think of it. What destroyed the dinosaurs? It's science. How is the meek going to fucking inherit the earth? I mean, I'm just telling you this shit now to get it into your fucking head when I take you into all of the scriptures. Because it's already 27 minutes, this fucking video. And, I'm going to have to go into another fucking video. Right? So, we've got warship. A warship is like what? In the ancient days, it was like the Arga Noah. Not the Ark of Noah, but the Arga Noah, which is the crescent moon sailing across the sky. Just like Noah. Noah had a warship. He had a warship because he was at war. The world was at war. Babylon was taken out back then. He was on the sea and he had to fucking survive. So there was a war going on around him and he took his warship and he fucking what? He prevailed. Isn't that right? At the end of time when the sun burns out, and there's no light left in the sun, then what? It's going to be just ice. So it's justice, isn't it? It's like an illegal, you're an illegal immigrant, or you're an ill eagle. You're an ill eagle, like fucking Rome, right? Rome was under the eagle. You're an ill eagle, like Nazi Germany. Germany is under the eagle. You're an ill eagle like fucking America, because America's fucking going down at present and they're losing power and they're an ill eagle, right? An ill eagle. I mean, fucking for fuck's sake, a religion. There's a re-legion to make a legion again. A legion of people, of believers. A legion, religion. A legion to make it over, to do it over, for fuck's sake. All of this shit is absolutely how they play these games. And this is why they fucking tell you straight out, they call it Apophis, but they will fail to say, time's over, that it's all about a serpent. A serpent that comes in the sky. A serpent that, just like the Bible says, everyone's going to fucking fear the coming of. This serpent. Right? This serpent strikes and hits the fucking earth. And what's going to happen after that? Well, the meek shall inherit the earth. Alright? That's what it's all about, isn't it? And then, after that, we have fucking a certain amount of time before the next fucking destruction, which is the sun absolutely burning out. And only leaving us with justice, or just ice. For example, alright, before this cuts out. Revelation 21:23. Next video I'll go into all of the fucking scriptures of my proving it. Alright? And the city had no need of the sun, neither of the moon to shine in it, for the glory of God did lighten it. And the Lamb is the light thereof. Yeah, the Lamb. Because there will be no sun. No sun. There will be no sun at all. What about Revelation 22:5? Alright, Revelation 22:5. Because only there will be just ice. Justice. Justice will be done. And there will be just ice left, won't there? Just ice. And there shall be no light there. And they need no candle, neither light of the sun. For the Lord God giveth them light, and they shall reign for ever and ever. For ever and ever. Ever and ever and ever and ever. Why? Because it'll be just ice. And the only lights needed will be God. God. And God's light is, you know, what? Hidden. It's hidden light. It's Amen Ra. Amen means hidden. Everyone says Amen. Yeah, amen. It's like fucking insulting man. It's going, amen. Yeah, amen. Yeah, it's like, oh, the dog's eating shit again. Brian Harvey will be like, oh, the dog. Oh, the dog's eating shit again. Oh, man. You know, amen. No, God gave us, what? The ability to fucking reign. Yeah? The ability to reign and fucking do our thing here until this destruction comes. And if we're smart enough, then we fucking what? Yeah? Then we know what God's word says. And if we know what God's word says, and we're smart enough to know what God's word says, then we're not just amen, are we? Amen. It's amen. Aaron's men. Aaron, the first high priest of fucking Israel. Yeah, Israel. Aaron, Moses' brother. That's what it's all about. Amen. Amen Ra. Amen Ra? Was it Amen Ra? No, it was Amen Ra. Amen Ra. Hidden light. Amen means hidden. And God is that hidden light, the light that shines in the darkness. The darkness comprehended it not, because it was hidden light. If you turn on a light, fucking darkness flees, therefore comprehends it. All right, stopping this, and I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. So, Amen Ra, just like I was talking about. Just stopped it and pressed record again. Okay, so there'll be no fucking light because Jesus Christ and God will be our light. There'll be no light. There'll be no fucking what? Huh? Night. They'll need no candle, neither light of the sun, for the Lord God giveth them light, and they shall reign forever and ever. There'll be no sun. There'll be no light there but God and Jesus Christ, because the sun will have burnt out. And the city had no need of the sun, neither of the moon, to shine in it. For the glory of God did lighten it, and the Lamb is light thereof. Right? So, you turn on a light, right? What happens? Huh? The darkness flees, doesn't it? So, if I get this and turn it around, look down here, and look how dark it is down there. You know, the dark. And if the light shined in the darkness and the darkness comprehended it not, why would the darkness flee? See how the darkness just fleed? Oh, the darkness fleed. Now if I turn it off, oh, the darkness comes back again. So the darkness obviously comprehends the light because it flees, doesn't it? So how can a fucking light be, what, hidden? Oh, that's right, it has to be hidden. Because if the light was in the darkness and the darkness comprehended it not, then it wouldn't flee. Right. Nah, wouldn't flee. I mean, for fuck's sake. So, we'll go back. Back again. Jeremiah. Isaiah. The nakedness shall be uncovered, yea, of Babylon. Thy shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance, and I will not meet thee as a man. And what vengeance is he going to take? And how is he not going to meet thee as a man? How is Jesus not going to meet ye as a man? What's this? Jeremiah 51:63. Now it shall be, when thou hast made an end of reading this book, that thou shalt bind and stone to it, and what? Cast it into the Euphrates? What's the next one? And thou shalt say, thus shall Babylon sink, and shall not rise from the evil that I will bring upon her, and they shall be weary. Thus far are the words of Jeremiah. So the vengeance is on what? Babylon. Babylon, the vengeance is on. I.e. what we were just on. Isaiah. Alright. 47:3. And he's not going to meet you as a man. So how is he going to meet you? How would he meet you if he's not going to meet you as a man? It says all this other fucking shit like, I'll spare no one. And I will not obliterate with a man. And I will not meet thee as a man. And I will not spare a man. So what is it? No, he will not, what? Just like it says in King James, will not meet you as a man. What, he's going to come as a monster and he's because he's coming in vengeance? Or he's going to come as an angel and he's not going to fucking... I respect your being a man? Or is he going to fucking, what, not come as a man at all and he's going to be something completely different? I mean, I'll tell you what it's all going to be. 100%. Alright? So let's see. It's all about 2 Peter 3:10. Right? 2 Peter 3:10. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night. Right? In the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, and the earth also and the works that are therein shall be burned up. Burned up as a thief in the night. Will come as a thief in the night. Heaven shall pass away, and the great noise, and the elements shall melt up with fervent heat, and the earth also, and the works that are therein shall be burned up. Now, how can that happen? Except by, say, the sun exploding, or fucking an asteroid coming in when we're expecting Jesus Christ to come 2,000 years later. 2,000 years later. 2,000 years after what? AD 30 or AD 33, which would make fucking at what? AD 30 would make it at 2030. Or if it's AD 33, it would make it 2033. But if it's 2029 when fucking Apophis comes and we see Apophis for the first time, would that be like seeing, something coming on the clouds? A fucking serpent coming on the clouds and everyone's going to be looking up to, and by 2036 we're going to be like, oh help, God help us, because it's going to strike. Wouldn't that sound like fucking Jesus Christ coming, for fuck's sake? And it's fucking funny how it's all coming and happening at around the fucking same time that it's all prophesied, isn't it? And it's all got to do with Apep, which is Apophis, is it not? Apep, a serpent, all right? And we're waiting for this to happen. This to happen, which is not fucking far-fetched considering we're all told this is what happened to the dinosaurs, And how exactly else will the meek inherit the earth? Yet alone all the fucking elite be hiding in the crevices of the rocks saying, protect us from the vengeance of the Lord. I mean, really? Apep, the fucking serpent, Apophis, order and truth, Mart, order and truth, opponent of light and Mart, But what did we just read about fucking Jesus Christ? Jesus Christ and God's going to be the light, and there will be no need for the sun. There will be no sun. Why will there be no sun? Because what's left at the end, after everything, after the sun burns out, just like we're told in science? Oh, just ice. And that's why we go around saying, oh, it's justice. Oh, it's justice, yeah? Oh, justice. Oh, justice this. Oh, justice that. Because you're a bunch of insipid heads who think that people fucking care for you, and the way this fucking world is designed, that, you know, your mother goes to the labor room, don't she, for delivery. Well, if you're coming out of your mother, how does she need anything delivered to her? Because you're coming from your mother, right? Isn't that right? You're coming out of your mother, so how does your mother need something delivered to her when you're already hers, and you're part of her, and you're inside of her? Isn't it all about you're the labor? You go to the labor room because you're the labor and you're getting delivered to the fucking government who's going to sign you over to be a laborer for them for the rest of your life. Yeah, just like, say, in Egypt, you know. Isn't that why it's labor and delivery? You've got the delivery in the labor room. Your mother's going through labor. No, your mother's going to fucking deliver you to the government who's going to make you their laborer for the rest of your fucking life. And it's got nothing to do with labor or delivery. Like, yous are all so brainwashed to fucking believe. How is it? It's got nothing to do with that. Nah, you'll just, make it out like that's something really cool and shit. Yous all make a fucking big deal out of it. And fucking, you all feel cotton wrapped and fucking, all cozy in your fucking little mindset. And you think, oh, labor and delivery is such a good thing. When you're fucking delivering a child to a fucking, what? Organization that's going to make it it's your laborer. That's when you sign it over with your birth certificate and everything. And what mother needs to have a child delivered? The child's already hers. The child's already fucking inside of her. She's already owns the child. There's no delivery. You know, there's only the revealing of the child. There's no fucking delivery. The mother and the child are one. You know, that's why the Bible says make two become one, for fuck's sake. So, why don't we go back here and jump into the good shit, Why don't we do that? So, Revelation, let's see, 10:5, yeah? Revelation 10:5. Who is the sea, And the angel which I saw stand upon the sea and upon the earth lifted up his hand to heaven. Lifted up his hand to heaven. And where's he standing? The angel which I saw stand upon the sea and upon the earth lifted up his hand to heaven. So, lifted up his hand to heaven, right? But what was before that? Fuck the heaven part. Because that's just him like going, oh, is it time? Then lifts his hand up to heaven. But, I saw him stand upon the what? The sea, and upon the earth. Who comes from east to west? Oh, Jesus Christ comes from east to west. And, by the way, while we're at it, what's the fucking stairway to heaven? And stairway to heaven, that fucking everyone's like, oh, the stairway to heaven and all that crap. What's the stairway to heaven actually all about, Do tell. Is it about north and south, or is it about east and west? Right? Because this is the right way, because the world's already flipped. The pillars have already flipped, because God bears up the pillars of it, a sealer. You understand? So, east to west. Why don't we go up here, say, for a moment, and have a look here, Oh, we have west. So shouldn't that be south? And then we have east. Oh, shouldn't that be north? But north is over here, and south is over here. So where's the stairway to heaven? Oh, is it east to west? Because Jesus Christ comes from east to west. But isn't it meant to be the other way around? Because it's a stairway to heaven. And if Jesus comes from east to west, shouldn't we be coming from, you know, what? Huh? East to west? No, we should be doing the opposite, shouldn't we? We should be coming from a west to east. Because Jesus comes from east to west. Isn't that right? So we have to walk opposite to him. Up to the stairway. So we come from the west. He comes from east to west. But we come from west to east. Because we have to take the stairway to heaven. Isn't that right? Yeah, that's right. So, ask yourself, what's the stairway to heaven? Is it north and south? Or is it east and west? Alright. So, and the angel which I saw stand upon the sea and upon the earth. Upon the sea and upon the earth. West and east and west. Right? Lifted his hand to heaven. As Jesus Christ, lifting his hand to heaven. For Jesus Christ is the fucking angel. Yes, the angel. And he swore by him who lives forever and ever, who created heaven and everything in it, the earth and everything in it, and the sea and everything in it, there will be no more delay. No more delay. So we're going to fucking talk about this angel. This angel. Right? This angel that I've been over times and times again. And you can go watch all my old videos on Scorpio 1980 and shit. And I've proven exactly who this angel is. 100%. Times over. Exactly. So, Revelation 18, 21. Okay. Revelation 18, 21. And a mighty angel took up a stone like a great milestone, a millstone, and it was cast into the sea. It was cast into the sea, saying, thus with violence shall that great city Babylon be thrown down and shall be found no more at all. Yeah, so what were we talking about just before in the first video and at the beginning of this about Jeremiah 51:63? You know, that stone, But that's what this is all about, Revelation, 18:21. That's what it's all about, let alone 10 fucking 5. Oh, just reading. It's the same angel. It's all about the fucking book and whose prophecy? Of Jeremiah's prophecy and a millstone, great millstone. So about the size of a V-dub, you know, about the size of a V-dub flying down and cast it into the sea. And what stone would that be? This great stone that's going to be cast into the sea. Have anything to do with Apep, you know, when this serpent is destroyed. Just like all your fucking movies and shit, that depict people destroying serpents and casting serpents down. Well, this Apophis going to be cast down in 2029 and 2036. And does Jesus come back? Does he not come back? Supposedly 2,000 years after 2030. 2,000 years is after AD 30 is 2030. Or is it 20 fucking 33? Because fucking AD 33 is 2,000 years after that date. It's 2033. Either way, 2029, you're going to be seeing this fucking massive serpent. And then you're going to know that it's going to fucking probably strike the earth in 2036, for fuck's sake. And when it strikes the earth, you reckon it'll be like a milestone, millstone that's cast into the sea, saying thus with violence shall that great city Babylon be thrown down? And is that why we're going to hear of wars and rumors of wars, and nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom? But, time is not yet. Be not a fucking afraid, Because all this has to come to pass. So fuck Iran and fuck fucking everything else. So think of it and fuck it all. Alright, so Jeremiah 51:63. Just like I fucking pointed out in the last one. Alright. Fuck. Jeremiah 51:63. Oh, fuck's sake. And it shall be, when thou hast made an end of reading this book, that thou shalt bind a stone to it and cast it into the midst of the Euphrates. Why? Because it was symbolic to show what was going to happen to Babylon. It's symbolic to show what this angel is going to do with the millstone. For the stone that he attaches to the book, right, is the millstone. And he casts it into the Euphrates. And the Euphrates represents the sea. The sea, right? Jeremiah 51:64. And thou shalt say, thus shall Babylon sink. Yeah, sink into the sea. And shall not rise from the evil that I will bring upon her. And they shall be weary. Thus far are the words of Jeremiah. It was all symbolic for what I'm telling you right now. Concerning fucking Revelation 10:5 and 18:21. And what is the sea? It's the sea of people. Is it not the sea of people? Isn't Babylon a sea? Babylon is the sea and that great beast, you know, in the Euphrates. Yeah, the great beast. The Leviathan that's in the sea is all, isn't it all fucking Babylon? It's in the sea of people. It's going to be all cast down, for fuck's sake. I mean, for fuck. Revelation 8:8. All right. Revelation 8:8. Same angel. All right. And who's this angel? This angel is whom? Jesus Christ, who is not going to meet you as a man. And the second angel sounded. And as it were a great mountain, burning with fire, was cast into the sea. And the third part of the sea became blood. Blood. How could the sea become blood? Because it's you're the sea of people. It's the sea is you. The sea is Babylon. The Babylon is the sea. A third of the sea became blood. Wow. We're talking about the same thing. The great mountain burning with fire was cast into the sea. It's the same angel that's casting the fucking, you know, the millstone, isn't it? Into the fucking sea. It's the same fucking angel. The time's over, right? And who is this angel really? Daniel? Here we go here. Daniel. Let me just go Dan. Right, let's see. 2:34. It's all about Nebuchadnezzar, and the statue, and God's kingdom, God's kingdom coming in. Thou sawest till that a stone was cut out without hands. That'd be like a mountain, is a mountain that's like a stone cut without hands, which smote the image upon his feet that were of iron and clay and break them into pieces. What does the image represent? The image represents the sea of people. The sea of people that are in Babylon. Isn't that right? Babylon, you are the sea of people. And what about 45? So that was whatever. And we'll go 34, we'll go 45. 45. For as much as thou sawest that the stone was cut out of the mountain. It's cut out of the mountain. So it was a stone cut out of the mountain without hands, and that it broke in pieces the iron, the brass, the clay, the silver, and the gold. The great God hath made known to the king what shall come to pass hereafter, and the dream is certain, and the interpretation thereof sure. So what is this? It's a mountain. It's a millstone. It's a mountain cast into the sea. Who is the sea? The sea is the image. It's the people. It's Babylon. Babylon of the sea, and Babylon the beast always rules in the sea of people. And the sea of people are what protects this fucking beast. This beast that we fucking all protect because, you know, we're all fucking want to be worldly and shit. And you can't survive unless you got money, and you can't survive unless you partake in the beast that, you know, we all live in, because we're the sea that the beast fucking lives in. That's why you all need cars, and why you all need fucking, the computers, and you need fucking stereos and TVs, and monitors, and you can't go without pictures on the walls. You need walls to put the pictures on, you know, all this shit, because that's what it is. It's the fucking, what? It's the image, is it not? So a Nebuchadnezzar statue, this is all bringing in God's kingdom. God's kingdom is when the statue is cast down. and God ends up ruling the fucking world. Is it not? Hmm? It's what it's all about. It's what this is all fucking about. Alright? So, we'll go back again. Cut out of a mountain, right? Cut out of a mountain, a great stone cut without hands. I saw us till the stone was cut out without hands. It was a mountain. It was a cut out of a mountain without hands. It was a mountain that was fucking, and the stone was cut without hands. Well, what's going to happen to Apophis when it comes in? It's going to get cut up, isn't it? It's going to break apart. And it's going to come in as like a stone when it was a mountain. Isn't that what happens when fucking shit like this takes over and fucking, you know, hits the earth? What's all this about then, huh? You know, and the second angel sounded as it were a great mountain burning with fire was cast into the sea. What sea? You're the sea. It's the same fucking shit. This is Jesus Christ. You know, casting, Michael, casting, gonna cast down the serpent. And the third part of the sea became blood. A third of fucking Babylon becomes blood, right? Because of this fucking what? This massive fucking stone mountain that's gone cast into the sea of people, for fuck's sake. I mean, Jeremiah, it's the same shit. Hmm? And thou saw that shall Babylon sink? And shall sink. Why will Babylon sink like that? Yeah? And it'll be fucking vengeance. Yeah? Because of this stone that Jeremiah's telling everybody about, which, yeah, it was, what? Hmm? Made an end to reading the book that thou shalt bind a stone to it, representing what I'm telling you about, this stone that's going to fucking be cast into the fucking Euphrates, because the Euphrates is what? The sea. It represents the sea of people. And the book represents what? Hmm? It represents Revelation. And Revelation is telling you about this stone that is cut out of a fucking mountain, for fuck's sake. Which is what? Revelation 18:21. Hmm? Revelation 18:21. All the same angel. All Jesus Christ telling you what's going to fucking happen. This is all more important than anything that you're fucking hearing in the news today about Iran and all these wars, blah, 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 and how everybody's fucking all up themselves talking. You know, this is what it's all about. And the mighty angel took up a stone like a great millstone and cast it into the sea, saying, thus with violence shall that great city, Babylon, be thrown down and shall be found no more at all. It's the same fucking shit. Babylon, yeah, the millstone, the stone cut out of a mountain without hands, right? I mean, the Jeremiah's prophecy, 51, go back again. It's the doom of Babylon, the Babylon. And what's it all about, yeah? What's it all about? Cast it into the sea, saying, thus with violence shall the great city Babylon be thrown down and shall be found no more at all. Why? Because, oh, that's right, there, yeah. As a mighty angel took up a stone like a great millstone and cast it into the sea, saying, thus with violence shall that great city Babylon be thrown down and shall be found no more at all. So, Revelation 10:5, same fucking shit, huh? Revelation 10:5. And you people think, you know, your worldly ways is entertaining. I mean, you've got the fucking absolute truth in front of you. And the angel which I saw stand upon the sea and upon the earth lift up his hand to heaven. It's Michael lifting up his hand to heaven. Michael, who comes from east to west. The sea and the fucking land. The land and the sea. Earth and water. Michael, you know, it's the stairway to fucking heaven. Yeah, you're getting all this? For fuck's sake. Right? And it's all about fucking Daniel, which I fucking went over. Alright? What are we going to do again? Daniel. Or Revelation 8:8 again. How long have I got? Doing pretty well. Time. And the second angel sounded as it were a great mountain burning with fire was cast into the sea, and the third part of the sea became blood. Right? The third part of the statue. The statue in Daniel, which that represents the same angel, Michael, that stands up. Right? Daniel. 2, 3, 4. two, three, four. Thou sawest till that stone was cut out without hands, which smote the image upon his feet, that were of iron and clay, and broke them to pieces. Yes, and broke the whole image down, Babylon down. Right? Babylon down. Daniel interprets the dream. Okay? So if you don't get all of that, and you don't understand that it's all about fucking not fearing the Lord, just like it says about the fucking wars that are going on at the moment, because if we go to Psalm... All right, 46:2. We'll know that therefore will not we fear through the though the earth be removed and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. No, we will not fear. We will not fear when this shit happens, when the destruction is near. Will we? We shall not fucking fear. Because it's always about the widow's son, isn't it? It's always about the widow's son. Who's the widow's son? Was, you know, Isis a widow because, you know, because Osiris got killed and she had a son and she bore the son like a widow because she was the widow's son? Did, what happened to Jesus Christ's father? Because Mary was the only one at the fucking foot of the cross, wasn't she? His mother. His mother was supposedly there and alive, but what happened to his father, his earthly father, Joseph? Was he dead, and so Jesus was the widow's son. And can a widow be fucking what? What's a widow all about? If we say, widow. Became a widower, lose one spouse through death. So is that a woman? Does it have to be a woman, or can it be a fucking man as well? A woman who has lost her spouse by death. He was recently widowed. He was recently widowed. So what is it? Is it he was recently widowed or she was recently widowed? Does it really matter? Because it's all about the fucking, what? The widow's son. Yeah. Always is, always fucking was. And that's why they fucking make all this fucking shit and mockery of it. This is what fucking Hiram Abiff is all about with the Masons. It's all about the widow's son. That's why they make it so important. Because, oh, it's all about the widow's son, isn't it? Always about the widow's son, Isis. It's always about the widow's son with Jesus. No, it's all about the widow's son with Hiram Abiff, for fuck's sake. And it's all about the good serpent and the bad serpent. It's all about the fucking, good dragon and the bad dragon. It's always about the good fucking lion and the bad lion. It's always about fucking east to west. And south, which is the lion Leo, being what? God, because your God is a devouring flame, O Hebrews. Yeah, and north is what? Air. And we all know who's fucking prince of the power of the air. Oh, north is always air, so the north is evil. Because, you know, it takes fucking, what? North to be created by the south, the east, and the west. Because if it wasn't for the south, east, and the west, north wouldn't fucking exist. But the south, the east, and the west have always fucking existed. Therefore, they're the trinity. They're the trinity. I mean, it's all a play on fucking words. It's a play on fucking everything. And people are so stupid, it just pisses me off. They fall for fucking stupidity. And fucking, you know, they think they fucking know something. Yeah, it's not fucking fun watching at all. So, 2 Peter, just to clear it up, right? 2 Peter 3:10. 2 Peter 3:10. Job been over, but, you know, whatever. Didn't think about all this. I just did it. I wrote it all down, what I needed to point out. Yeah, lift up your eyes to the heavens and look at the earth below. The heavens will vanish like smoke. The earth will wear out like a garment and its people will die like gnats. But my salvation will last forever. Stars of heaven will be dissolved. The skies will be rolled up like a scroll and all their stars will fall like withered leaves on a vine and foliage on a fig tree. The earth is utterly broken apart. The earth is split open. The earth is shaken violently. They will perish, but you remain. They will all wear out like a garment, like clothing, but you will change them and they will be passed on. You will change them like in the twinkling of the eye. Isn't that right? The mountains will melt beneath him and the valleys will split apart. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away. I mean, you get it? What's it all about? It's all about this. Apophis. It's all about Apophis. And then after Apophis, the sun burning out. I mean, don't take a genius to know the science that is the Bible at all. All right? Yeah. Think I'm crazy? Think what you will. But this is the most important information that you should ever be holding in your heart at all. Ciao. What do you think that is? What do you think it is? Obviously, it's Ayers Rock. But what is all this shit coming off it? From thousands of years of rainfall coming off the top of the rock and washing onto the ground. What is all that shit? What is it? Would that be like fucking minerals and metals? Minerals and metals? So where do minerals and metals come off of? Because you don't see rocks doing this shit. This has got its own ecosystem. This massive rock in the center of Australia has its own ecosystem, right? Rocks that have their own ecosystem, right, are like this one, which is sitting in a fucking foreign land because this rock shouldn't be here, right? And this rock's in Alice Springs, and it's alien to the land that it's in. That's why all of these fucking minerals and fucking metals are fucking being washed off it and causing its own ecosystem around it. So what do you think that is? What do you think it is? Because they always, always will show you stuff like, craters. Craters and shit. But they'll never show you fucking what cause those craters. Yeah, those craters. So this here is what fucking killed the dinosaurs, right? Full stop. This here is what killed the fucking dinosaurs. This is Ayers fucking Rock in Australia, and it's alien to the fucking land that it's sitting in. The Aboriginals believe that this, in their dream time, came out of the sky, right? And smashed into the earth and created a new earth, a new world, and sucked the earth together, and this is what's holding what was now holding that earth, that new world together. So Ayers Rock is what's holding the world together. Because the world was different before Ayers Rock came out of the sky, according to fucking Aboriginal Dreamtime, and smashed into the earth. And when it smashed into the earth, it turned the earth red. Red. So we have the sacred red soil. And it goes into all kinds of cultures, and it's all about the red soil and how the red soil is so sacred, right? It's sacred soil. It's always red. So this is what, apparently, according to the Aboriginals, smashed into the earth, right? Smashed into the earth, and they were fucking around living to be able to tell this fucking tale, to pass this down in dream time, right? And fucking caused destruction upon the earth. And when they come back out of hiding, the whole earth, as they knew it, was turned red. It turned into a red earth. Right? This here is an asteroid. This is what killed the fucking dinosaurs. I don't need to hear your bullshit about, oh, we didn't live with the dinosaurs and all that crap. It's fucking absolutely bullshit. I mean, for fuck's sake, you know, that's just fucking absolutely hearsay. Nobody knows for fucking sure. So, it can cut both fucking ways, like it's a double-edged fucking sword. It's a he said fucking, she said fucking bullshit. Of course we live with the dinosaurs. How the fuck do you think all of those massive fucking temples and megalithic stones and fucking shit all around the world, how do you think they were all created? By UFOs? Or massive fucking dinosaurs? You think dinosaurs moved those fucking massive two ton fucking megaliths and fucking 3 and 4 ton fucking megaliths into place and built fucking, temples and shit? Moved fucking mountains? Because it sure wasn't fucking men with sticks and pulleys, you fucking morons. So this here is obviously what killed the fucking dinosaurs, right? And the Aboriginals fucking have this in their dream time, saying that the fucking this came was like a massive egg in the sky, and it smashed into the earth and turned the earth fucking red. And they're around to fucking witness it, and they pass it down to their fucking children. All right. So this fucking thing here, and you can look at the fucking what, all the houses in the background. Yeah, all that little civilization out back there in the background, a little fucking community next to fucking the rock and then Alice Springs, right? And fucking think of how big this fucking rock really is. This fucking rock that took out the fucking dinosaurs. And you think Apophis is a big fucking joke, all right? Why don't we have a different fucking view? This, same shit, look at all of this fucking stuff here. It's got its own ecosystem around it. It's all fucking minerals and metals that have washed off the rock for thousands of years. And it's caused this massive fucking ecosystem that is foreign and alien to the land that this rock is sitting in. So this whole land here was not like this until this rock fucking smashed into the earth and caused the destruction and landed where it fucking landed, which is right here in Alice Springs. All right? So just think about that, because the Mayans, it's in their fucking documented in their history that they sailed to a foreign land all the way down the bottom of the fucking world, and they sailed into the center of this land, and they sailed around this massive rock, right? And this was all an inland sea at one point. There's a massive inland sea, and this rock was apparently fucking surrounded by ocean, and the fucking Mayans came down here and sailed around Ayers Rock. Now you've got to ask yourself, was that when the world was one supercontinent and it was Pangaea, Pangaea land, Pangaea, right? Is that when it was like that? And think about all this shit, because I've talked about this crap over and over and over again. Like, fucking nothing I'm telling you here is not fucking whatever, yeah? It's not new. It's nothing fucking new whatsoever at all. All right, we go here. I will go all the way down. I'm just repeating myself as per fucking usual, right? Let's see. Origins of Species. Eden, Australia. Rex, Scorpio 1980. Amero, Apophis, Apep. 8 years ago, right? Fucking 8 years ago. Go down. Nibiru, Apep, Apophis. 11 years ago. It was 12 years ago, actually, because it was in fucking, you know what, 2000, yeah, whatever, it's at a year, because it's all, it should be fucking have passed over to 12 by now. I mean, for fuck's sake, all of this shit is absolutely legit. This is what it's all about. This is what killed the dinosaurs, and this, and the fucking something similar to the size of this, is what we're fucking dealing with in 2029, 2036, right? And don't take a genius to know how fucking important this fucking matter is. All right? So all they ever do is show you craters. They'll go, oh, look at the crater, or the Arizona crater, or let's say the fucking, you know, Wolf Creek fucking crater. Yeah, the Wolf Creek crater. I mean, and look at this thing. In the center of this, it's got its own ecosystem. Its own ecosystem. And the ecosystem in the center of this, right, is basically the same ecosystem that's around the outside of the rock, right? It's foreign, it's alien to the territory, to the fucking land that it's in, sitting in. All right, so this here is left over, but what's going on in the center of this fucking crater, which you find exactly the same thing with Arizona craters and many other craters all around the world, is the impact point, obviously, and where it left all its minerals and its fucking metals at the fucking point of impact and changed the absolute soil, the absolute fucking texture and the fucking makeup of that fucking soil, and left its own ecosystem with it, the impact. But these things don't just fucking hit these places and just shatter and pulverize into nothing. You know, they do pulverize and break apart and scatter fucking rocks and shit all over the place for fucking miles and miles in all directions, but they bounce, and they bounce across the world, right? This thing here bounced from fucking a crater to another crater, and it could have even bounced again and fucking then landed where it fucking is now in Alice Springs. It didn't just fucking come into the earth and smash into the earth. It struck numerous times. It shattered itself all over the fucking place. It pulverized the fucking ground and the fucking area around the fucking, you know, where it fucking struck and caused these craters. You know, and just think of it. Crater, a creator. And what is this thing going to fucking do when it fucking smashes into the earth? It's going to create a new fucking earth, isn't it? It's going to change everything as everybody knows it, and it's going to create a new thing. So therefore, it makes a crater, or it is a creator, because it fucking smashes into the fucking earth. And just the fucking, you know, word implies creator. A crater implies creator. Because when these things fucking happen, they change the makeup of everything, let alone the fucking soil in the center of these fucking craters. You know, by asteroids or fucking meteors, it's all the same. If they're big enough, this is what's left behind. And I've gone over it before and over it before, just like I was showing to you in here and fucking stuff, up here, wherever it is, the Origin of Species, Eden, Australia, Rex Gilroy, etc., that fucking, it's known in science, in the fucking inner circles of science and shit now, that they reckon Ayers Rock bounced from Arizona, the Arizona crater, to Wolf Creek crater, all the other way around, and then fucking landed where it is now in Alice Springs. Right? In Alice Springs. And when you're seeing this thing coming through the sky, what would you think it was? Because it was burning up in all different colors and shit. Would it be like a rainbow? Would it be like a serpent? Right? You think of the lorikeets that I've been showing you. A lorikeet and their feathers. All right? Their feathers. I'll just go here again and go, lorikeet. I mean, I've talked about all this times over. All this I'm fucking simply repeating. A rainbow lorikeet. What is it called? A Lorini. Lorini is a tribe of small, medium-sized arboreal parrots. Oh, well, it's a lorikeet. Right? Rainbow lorikeets. Rainbow lorikeets. There's this Lorini shit. So, Lorini, it looks basically the same as a lorikeet to me. Rainbow fucking lorikeet. Right? So, this rainbow lorikeet is a fucking bird with fucking rainbow feathers on it. Think of all the serpents and shit, right? Think of all the serpents we're talking about. Feathered serpents, plumed serpents. I mean, they even tell you T-Rex today, right? T-Rex is a fucking big chicken that had fucking feathers. That's what they tell you in science classes to fucking children. To your, if you got children, your children are going to fucking science classes learning about dinosaurs. They're telling you and your children now to believe that fucking, what, T-Rex was a scavenger? Not a fucking king of the beasts, but a scavenger that looked like a chicken and had chicken feathers. I mean, what are dragons? Do you reckon a dragon needed feathers to be able to fly? Hmm? It's all about a serpent, is it not? And isn't the serpent the fucking, what, the scorpion? Isn't the scorpion and the serpent the eagle? Didn't fucking the tribe of Dan change their symbol or their emblem to a fucking, you know, a fucking, what, eagle? But it was a fucking serpent. Isn't it all about the judgment and judgment, and yet this world has to be judged? So we have, obviously, you know, Jesus Christ comes, like in Moses' time, right? And Moses fucking held the serpent up in the wilderness, so too the Son of Man shall be held up. So in Moses' time, everybody bowed down and worshipped the serpent on the pole and got healed. Now Jesus, as the Son of Man, yeah, is also fucking put on the pole, and everybody here fucking bows down and gets healed by him and has their fucking sins forgiven, you know, because as Moses held that serpent up in the wilderness, so too Jesus is that fucking serpent and represents that serpent that everybody must be healed and saved by, right? What is he going to do in the West? In the mirror? Because this is all mirrors. I've got been over it all. So what's he going to fucking do in the West? Is he going to do the opposite of save you? Opposite of come here and die for your sins? What would be the opposite of him coming here and dying for your sins? Wouldn't he come here and kill you for your sins? For not listening to what he fucking come here to teach you last time? Didn't he come here and be forgive you because you know not what you do, then teach you what you fucking should have known? And then he had to fucking die for you. And when he returns, there's no more forgiveness anymore because he's already given you the chance of repentance, told you to repent. Then if you didn't repent and listen to him, you know, because that's what John the Baptist was telling everybody, repent for the kingdom draweth nigh. And Jesus Christ knew that he had to come and fucking prepare you for the kingdom, you know, because he's fucking knew not what you do. He had to teach you what to do. And if you didn't listen to him, what's he going to do when he comes back? Because he's obviously coming back for what? Vengeance. Yeah, he's coming back to what? Judge and make fucking war. So this lorikeet is basically like the fucking plumed serpent or the fucking rainbow serpent. The rainbow serpent. And what's a plumed serpent? What's a rainbow serpent? If you saw this thing coming in, you see fucking asteroids fucking coming through the sky at night. You see them come through in all kinds of fucking different color spectrums, don't you? As they burn up in the sky. Because that's the whole point, isn't it? So you'd see a plume behind them, obviously. You see the plume, and you see them fucking breaking up in the sky, right? And shedding their fucking metals and fucking skin, per se, in the fucking sky, and that's all rainbow colours. So what would be a rainbow serpent? Huh? Let alone fucking, you know, the fucking whatever, Apep, which is the fucking serpent of fucking Egypt, right? So Apep and fucking Mart, what, fight each other, right? And everyone wants the good person, you know, the good guy to fucking win. But sometimes a bad guy wins. Don't we all know that because of the fucking story of Cain and Abel? I mean, isn't that the whole point? Because that's about fucking, you know, that's all about fucking, you know, ages and shit. So sometimes Mart wins, and sometimes, what, Apep wins. Isn't that right? And you've got movies out there and all kinds of shit where they're fucking fighting a pep and they have to fucking keep a pep a bay. And that's a continual cycle of a pep always coming, this massive serpent coming and shit. And, you know, the god has to fucking get up, stand up and fucking do his fucking job to fucking protect everyone from a pep. Well, you know, it doesn't fucking work all like that all the fucking time, right? It's all about fucking cycles and ages and turns because that's what this is representing. Yeah, that's the whole point of this. Fucking echoes and shit that happen fucking on one side and fucking happens on the other. You know, the butterfly effect, etc., etc. That's what this is depicting. And the mirrors. So if Jesus Christ comes and fucking dies for your sins here, he comes back and he fucking takes you out for your sins for not listening to him, right? And to begin with, and brings in the kingdom of God. Right, and the meek have to inherit the earth for the kingdom of God to be there at the end when the sun burns up and all that's left because the sun's gone is fucking what? Jesus Christ and God being your light, because there's no sun and there's no moon, so they're your fucking light and they're your candle and fucking what? The sun's burnt up and the fucking kingdom of heaven's here. Yeah. So, I've been over that, and I'll go into it probably more in the next video. But as you can see, this is what it's all about. It's all about fucking, you know, Apophis. And you can laugh all you fucking like, because, you know, they know you're stupid, they dumb you down, and they teach you shit like fucking T-Rex is the king of the fucking dinosaurs, and now they teach your children that T-Rex is a fucking chicken with fucking feathers. Wonder why? Because, all these things here are basically dinosaurs, aren't they, too? Because now we're told also that birds are all dinosaurs. These might as well be little fucking, like I said in my fucking prior video, little raptors. That's basically the same shit. And they've got the claws and everything in the right fucking places. As the raptor claws out of fucking so-called, or is it? That stupid Jurassic Park. So why don't we go plume. Definition. Plume, a long, soft feather or arrangement of feathers used by a bird for display or worn by a person for an ornament, right? A long cloud of smoke or vapor resembling a feather as it spreads from its point of origin. And what is that? What is that? Point of origin spreads from its point of origin. Where would its point of origin be? When this thing's flying into the fucking atmosphere. Just think about that. Now, I'm going to quickly go here and show you that I was talking about all this back in May last year, and it didn't go through, all right? So, Studio Classic, because, you know, beta's shit, obviously. I'm going to go to, where is it, Video Manager. I'm going to put in Foresight. Foresight. Alright. Blocked worldwide. Blocked worldwide with four views. Let four people fucking... What? Views. Or is that my views? I don't understand how it was blocked worldwide and I was getting fucking thumbs up and shit. So, why don't we go here? Alright. Here. And let's see. 10:36. So this is when the cops fucking tried to pull us over. And then somebody called them in, radioed in, alright? Got radioed in and told them to leave us alone. Because everything they fucking I do, they watch through this fucking camera. I don't know if they're still doing it, because I haven't had pictures taken on me for a while, but they're fucking still happening, right? I have had them in the fucking past 2 months, 2 months ago, fucking for 2 months or something, it hasn't taken a fucking photo of me, but it's been documented that it's fucking still happening. So, let's see, 10:36. Where am I? 10:36. All right? So this is what I was talking about before the cops.
This whole area, this whole fucking area, we're driving through now, right into the other side of fucking Melbourne. Rocks and shit scattered everywhere, fucking all over the fucking surface of this land. Massive fucking stone fucking rocks, left over from when the last asteroid fucking hit. Yeah, that last fucking asteroid. They're fucking all the way to the other side of Melbourne, all the way out here. You can't blame that shit on fucking volcanoes. There's no volcanoes around here large enough to blow stones in the fucking every direction that fucking far. That was from the last meteor. The meteor that bounced from fucking Arizona and fucking come over and hit Australia and fucking Wolf Creek and then landed where it fucking landed is fucking rock. You people better wake the fuck up. They're gonna fucking pull a big stooge on your fucking asses. It's all about Apophis. 2029, 2036. This whole area covered from fucking surface of the fucking ground everywhere. Just rocks. They turned them all into the fucking, what do you call it, fences and shit. This whole area, all out here, fucking rocks everywhere. Just scattered all over the surface of the land. The same all the way into the fucking other side of Melbourne. And it was the leftover fucking remnants of the shockwave that struck Australia when Ayers Rock fucking landed. You don't think Ayers Rock's a fucking meteor? Just look at the fucking minerals coming out of it. They'd come out of the sky like a big red egg. The Aboriginals talk about it. And this whole land scattered with fucking massive hailstone rock fucking sized boulders. They go fucking flying in all directions and landing. You people gotta wake the fuck up. Wake the fuck up. They're gonna fight, they're gonna fucking, this is gonna rise and rise and rise until they fucking all try to bring the world together with Apophis, the destroyer. Apophis, the destroyer. Yeah, the serpent. Man. All this land, everywhere, scattered with rocks. They've cleaned it all up. Still fucking remnants of it everywhere. You got common sense, enough common sense to realize if there's rocks scattered all over the surface of the ground, something happened to put them there. No volcanoes around here big enough to blast rocks the size of the rocks that are fucking all over the place. In all fucking directions, all around Melbourne. You drive through these areas, you see all the old fences that are just made stacked fucking rocks. All the rocks they've cleaned up from their fucking land because they're just scattered all over the surface. Just scattered, landed fucking from the sky. You people have got a fucking big deal to learn. Now, asteroid fucking strike here, landed here last time. This time it's your turn. That's why the poles flipped. Poles flipped. Welcome to the new world. You're all in the fucking ancient fucking past, yous are. You're all crumbling. Empires are falling. Crumbling down. Mighty King Lake.
Where all the fucking fires happened last time. Right in front of us. 2009.
Whole area scattered. Massive rocks. All over the surface.
So the cops try to pull us over and then fucking get called, radioed in and told to leave us alone because they're watching everything that I do.
Up to fucking Paul's Creek and up the top end of Australia where it's all sunken under the, you know, fucking sea level where the Mayans fucking sailed in. The Mayans come down here and sailed into central Australia and sailed around the fucking Ayers Rock. It's all fucking shells and shit everywhere. Inland sea. Feel that inland sea again and you watch this fucking whole area change. All of Australia will fucking change. Only thing preventing it from coming up again.
Turned around again and drove off. They got radioed in.
All area scattered with fucking hailstones the size of fucking whatever, melons. Melons. So the bigger ones, where they fucking fall.
That there's King Lake. That's where all the fires, that's where I fucking was sitting up on top of, and the helicopter flew up, straight up towards us, up the, over those fucking telephone poles and telephone fucking electricity poles and shit, right here. And this is King Lake. And this is where the fires were in 2009 on Black Saturday, right? And the same shit was going on back then with fucking all this, you know, crap and shit, just absolutely undeniably fucking harp technology. And all you people talking about Jew weapons and laws, law weapon, the law's lasers and shit, it's all basically exactly the same thing, but on a major scale. That's what these radio towers are. They can fucking direct energy into a fucking part of the fucking, you know, ionosphere, and it'll beam back down, and that's how they burn up places. They're not doing it with fucking whatever, like the Jew weapons that the fucking military use and have on their fucking, whatever, fucking their, you know, ships and fucking whatever, helicopters and shit now. And they can, you know, direct energy at fucking shit and blow stuff out of the fucking sky like all the fucking, recent, not so recent fucking aeroplanes that just went missing and nobody knows what happened to them. They'll burn up by fucking laws, lasers and Jew weapons, direct energy weapons. But the harp is done on the major scale. So if they're doing anything, it's all happening with the harp technology, right? And they direct the fucking harp or the array of fucking antennas up into a certain part of the ionosphere and it fucking reflects back down and fucking hits the earth and they can burn up massive parts and start fires on hot fucking days, let alone they can keep it hot on fucking hot days by keeping the fucking, you know, cold air above the fucking heat, or they can push the fucking cold air back down and make it less hot. Let alone, like I was saying in that fucking video, all typical wank video, you know, they can fucking set off massive sonic booms, it's been proven here in Melbourne, and make it rain for a week. So they don't even need firefighters out there fighting fires, right? All this shit is all fucking bullcrap. Let alone the fact that, you know, if you look up firefighters, New South Wales, pedophiles, right, in fucking the news and shit, you'll see that firefighters have to go through this bullshit to prove that they're fucking all right around children and not pedophiles and all this crap before they can be a fucking certified firefighter now. And they fucking basically kicked a whole bunch of firefighters off the team because they were refusing to fucking prove that they were not pedophiles because they were... They all felt that the government was trying to fucking what? It was trying to fucking pull the shit that's obviously going on now. Let alone they were fucking claiming and insulting them and trying to claim that they were pedophiles. I mean, for fuck's sake. All this shit doesn't fucking happen. So, yeah, fucking, Kinglake was done the same fucking way. Everyone knew that it was fucking all, the shit should have been burnt up. There should have been burn-offs. They weren't allowing people to clean up on the sides of the road, let alone in between fucking, you know, civilization and the fucking bush. And it was all fucking set up exactly the same way. And there was fucking energy weapons going on back then. It was all done by fucking HAARP. And I was talking about those antennas and shit back then, you know, when all this fucking crap was going on. And fucking, it's absolutely fucked. Yeah, I've fucking talked about laws and Jew and all these fucking weapons and the aeroplanes and stuff all over fucking my, whatever you call it, videos and fucking Facebook page. And I've had somebody else sit there and ask me recently about spiders and snakes and this heat and stuff crawling up into the engine bay and stuff. And I mean, I'm sure it happens in Australia somewhere. I mean, I've been looking for a whitetail spider for fucking UK media, whatever, channel and shit for a long time now. I haven't found one, but fucking, there's so many kookaburras around me and around this area that any snake that's fucking game enough to fucking, you know, show itself around here is fucking easily picked up by a kookaburra and have its fucking skull smashed against a fucking tree or into the ground and eaten by the kookaburras. So, not around here. I know where I am. There's a fucking, you're gonna find a snake crawled up in your engine bay in this fucking heat. But obviously I'm going to have to stop this now and, you know, fucking I'll have to continue and talking about other stuff and I'll go into more scriptures for you and stuff. But I'm just saying you know, what we're dealing with here, because it's all about Apophis. It's all about Apophis and it's all about the time being cut short for the elite. For the elite of yous. Yeah, the elite of yous. And I'll go into all of that next. All right. Ciao. Alright, so, radiate in, huh? It's like I just played to you in the last one. 1540, find the Stooges.
Only thing preventing it from going lush again.
So, yeah, these cops pulled over, put on their lights to pull us over, because everything was being watched through my fucking camera, which has been proven times over in all my fucking videos and shit. And, you know, crap, I don't know, they haven't taken photos of me fucking for a while, you know, about 2 months and shit, but fucking back then, this cop car pulled over to pull us over, it was all to do with us, and then they got radioed in, and then turned around again, and went back the opposite direction. Cop cars don't fucking do that, and it's fucking wrong, and they were obviously pulling over to fucking do us with, you know, fucking whatever, try to pull us over and shit. But this was back in May the 3rd, 2019. Alright. They got their lights on. They pull their fucking lights on. Come over. They were trying to fucking pull us over. And this is why it wouldn't go through. Jailbreak. Right here. Bon Scott, Malcolm Young, AC/DC, Jailbreak came on the radio. And they fucking didn't allow this to go through. And there's videos of it, of me fucking pointing out this shit and stuff, but that's what this is from. So yet again,
I
the cops. Gonna try to pull us over. And there's Kinglake, what was burnt in 2009. Absolutely fucking went up in smoke and fucking, you know, it's really close. This is like about half an hour away from where I'm at right now. Okay? So, where am I at? It's all about, let's see, Matthew or Mark. We'll go to Mark 13:20. Okay, plume definition. Mark 13:20. Bible Hub. Right, if the Lord had not shortened those days, nobody would be saved. But for the sake of the elect whom he has chosen, he has shortened them. At that time, if anyone says to you, look, here is the Christ, or there he is, do not believe it. Now, what are we talking about here? We're talking about the abomination of desolation. We're talking about Israel and the Holy Land. All right, if we go back. For in those days there will be a tribulation unmatched to the beginning of God's creation until now and never to be seen again. A tribulation to do with the abomination of desolation in the Holy Land, right? In the Holy Land, in fucking Israel as you know it today. This is all going to fucking, you know, pan out. But when that's cut short, is it's going to be cut short by what? It's going to be cut short by Apophis, okay? And we can keep on going back. How miserable those days will be for pregnant and nursing mothers. Pray that it will not occur in the winter. This is what's going to happen in the Holy Land and in fucking Iran and fucking with Russia and with China and with America and fucking all America's stupid allies that think America's going to fucking like save them. Like, yeah, right. They're not saving anyone. And let no one in the field return for his cloak. I'm reading it backwards, obviously. Right, let no one on the housetop go back inside to retrieve anything. Okay? So when you see the abomination of desolation standing where it should not be, let the reader understand. Then let those who are in Judea flee to the mountains. Flee to the mountains, because it's just going to go off over there. Absolutely go fucking off. So when, you know, you will be hated by everyone because my name, but the one who preserves to the end will be saved. So where were we? We were at Matt or Mark 13:20. Alright, we'll go back to 13:20. Now we'll go forward. At that time, if anyone says to you, look, here is the Christ, or there he is, do not believe it. For the false Christ and false prophets will appear and perform signs and wonders that would deceive even the elect, if that were possible. But the time's going to be cut short for the elect, isn't it? So be on your guard. I have told you everything in advance. Everything in advance. But in those days after that tribulation, which will be the fucking Holy Land going up, and fucking, you know, everything you're seeing in Syria now for fucking years happening to Israel, as you know it, and fucking Iran and the wars with fucking Iran and fucking, you know, Russia and China and America and everything that's going to go till fucking 2029, right? 2029, right? Get it? The sun will be darkened and the moon will not give its light. All right? After the tribulation, because this is what how it's going to be cut short. This is Apophis that's going to cut it short. The stars will fall from the sky and the powers of heaven will be shaken by Apophis, by Apep, which they're going to fucking use against you, whether you like it or fucking not. You know, whether you fucking believe Apep has anything to do with Christ or you don't. It's going to be used against you by the fucking elite that run this world, all right? At that time, they will see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory. Because what's going to cut short? What's going to cut short the wars and everything and that tribulation? That's going to be cut short for the elect. Think of it. Hmm? and he will send out the angels to gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of heaven. So he's going to fucking cut it short for the elect. So how is it going to be cut short for the elect? It's going to be cut short by Apophis, by Apep, by the serpent, the destroyer, right? That's going to come in the sky. And it's fucking, you know, just as it fucking has been prophesied times over by many civilizations regarding a plumed, feathered fucking serpent. You know, like I've fucking proven times over, which it all fucking equates to this. This right here. And this. This right here. Times over. Now this is what it's talking about. So the fucking, the whole point of this is, you know, cut short. What is going to cut short that tribulation? It's just told you. It's just been written there right in front of you in this fucking book. Mark chapter 13:20. If the Lord had not shortened those days, nobody would be saved. Saved by whom? By all the wars and man himself. Man himself has to be saved from fucking killing and wiping us all off the fucking face of the earth. And what's going to cut those days short? What's going to cut the fucking wars short that are going to go to 2029 regarding Israel and the Holy Land and fucking Iran and fucking et cetera, et cetera? Apophis is going to cut it all short. I mean, it doesn't take a fucking genius because Apophis is coming in 2029. And these wars are going to be going up until 2029 and just going to get under all of your skin and shit and make you all fearful about what's going on with the fucking, you know, media and the fucking, what's going on with the fucking, what, you know, economy of fucking America and your own economies and having to go to war and nuclear weapons and fucking this and fucking that. All right, and we can look at exactly the same thing in Matthew 24:22. All right, so we'll go Matt 24:22. Matt 24:22. Okay. If those days had not been short, cut short, nobody would be saved. But for the sake of the elect, those days will be shortened. What days? The war. The war. The tribulation. On fucking Israel as you fucking know it today, and the Holy Land, and the wars, and the rumors of wars, and the nations rising against nations, and kingdoms against kingdoms. I mean, just read the whole book. I haven't got time to go through it all. I'll point out the fucking obvious for you, alright? At that time, if anyone says to you, look, here is the Christ, or there he is, do not believe it. The Christ. For false Christs and false prophets will appear and perform great signs and wonders that would deceive even the elect, if that were possible. Right, see, I have told you in advance. So if they tell you, there he is in the wilderness, do not go out. Or here he is in the inner rooms, do not believe it. Why? Because you've got to wait for Apophis. For just as the lightning comes from the east and flashes as far as the west, so will be the coming of the Son of Man. East to west. East to west. It's all about east to west. It's all about the angel who stands in the sea and on the land. Yeah? Representing Jesus Christ. East to west. The sun comes east to west. What does the sun do? What do the fucking Masons say? Oh, I've been traveling east to west and from west to east again. Because, you know, that's a secular motion. So we have to fucking, what? It's all about the east, is it not? And fucking Jesus comes from east to west, but for the stairway to heaven, we have to go from west to east. The following back around to come east to west again. The coming of the Son of fucking Man. All right? Wherever there is a carcass, there the vultures will gather. Immediately after the tribulation of the Holy Land and the wars and the fucking rumors of wars and nation rising against nation and kingdom against kingdom, Iran, Israel as you know it today, of those days the sun will be darkened and the moon will not give its light, the stars will fall from the sky and the powers of heaven will be shaken. All right? At that time the sign of the Son of Man will appear in heaven, Apophis. Right, the Apophis, the stone that we're all waiting for, that prophecy that I've already covered. And all the tribes of the earth will mourn. They will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. That's why you don't believe anybody if they say, here is the Christ, or there is the Christ. You know, here is the Christ, or there is the fucking Christ. Because it's not about that. And I've covered that already. How did I cover that? Because it's all about what? Isaiah 47:3. Though, should I just cut over here and do that for a minute? Isaiah 47:3. All right. This is what it's all about. Thy nakedness shall be uncovered, yea, thy shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance, and I will not meet thee as a man. So how is he going to meet you? He's going to meet you as the stone that cuts down Nebuchadnezzar's statue. He's going to meet you as the stone that is cut out of a mountain, right? That's cut out of the mountain in the book of Daniel. He's going to meet you as the millstone that is thrown into the fucking sea, and you're the sea of people. All right? And he will send out his angels with a loud trumpet call, and they will gather his elect from the four winds, from one end of heavens to the other. Okay? That's what it's all about. And what's it all about? It's got to be cut short. Cut short for the elect. So how is it cut short for the elect? What I just read out to you, isn't it? Immediately after those tribulations of those days, the sun will be darkened, the moon will not give its light, the stars will fall from the sky or heaven, and the powers of heavens will be shaken. At that time, the sign of the Son of Man will appear in heaven, and all the tribes of the earth will mourn. They will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. Now, you have to fucking realize that Apophis is going to come between, you know, the Earth and our satellites that are in orbit. So the satellites that are in orbit, that's how close it's going to come to the Earth in 2029. So in 2029, you're all going to physically see it. You're going to fucking see it. You're going to be able to go outside, look into the sky and say, what the fuck? That is huge. And freak the fuck out. That's what's going to fucking happen. So you're going to see a sign in the fucking sky in 2029 on Friday the 13th, which is Apophis. Right, and you're going to see it so close to the fucking Earth that it's in between the Earth and the satellites that fucking our armies and fucking NASA and fucking China and anybody else has up in the sky. It's going to be that close to the fucking Earth. So just think of that, you know, along with everything that I fucking told you already. Because this is what it's all about, being cut fucking short, okay? Cut short, Matthew 24:22, Mark 13:20. Right? So, now we've gotten that off my fucking chest. Why don't we go into, say, like Babylon, bunkers, space station and shit. Because what's going to happen? We've just seen what's going to happen. I mean, it's all about basically the clefts of the rocks. They're all going to hide in the clefts of the rocks, isn't it? So we'll go Isaiah 2:19, shall we? Isaiah 2:19. The day of reckoning. All right? Men will flee to caves in the rocks and holes in the ground, away from the terror of the Lord and from the splendor of his majesty. When he rises to shake the earth. Shake the earth how? And why? Oh, that's right. For vengeance. Thy nakedness shall be uncovered, Babylon's nakedness, right? Yes, thy shame shall be seen, thy shame. I will take vengeance, and I will not meet thee as a man. Not meet thee as a man. So how is he going to meet you? As the stone that the angel casts into the sea. Casts onto the fucking feet of the statue of Nebuchadnezzar, only to reign in the fucking, you know, kingdom of God, which is all about the West. Yeah, he come and died for you, and then he's going to fucking kill you for your sins to reign in the fucking kingdom in the South. That's what it's all about. So he brings the kingdom of God. And the South is when the sun fucking basically burns up and all that's left is just ice. Yeah, just ice, because, yeah, there's no more sun and there's no more light, and there's only fucking light that there will be is from fucking who? Jesus Christ and God for you. Okay? So in that day, men will cast away their idols of silver and gold, the idols they made to worship, away to the moles and bats. I don't know if this, what do you call it? Rendition of the Bible's any good, but whatever you see. Men will fucking flee to the caves, in the rocks and the holes in the ground. All right? Jump over 20 and we'll go to 21. You can read it in the fucking, your own Bible. Right? They will flee to caverns in the rocks and crevices in the cliffs, away from the terror of the Lord and from the splendor of his majesty when he rises to shake the earth. Yeah, rises to shake the earth. All right, it's the same thing as Revelation 6:14. Okay, Revelation 6:14. Okay, the sky receded like a scroll being rolled up, and every mountain and island was moved from its place. And the stars of the sky fell to the earth like unripe figs dropping from a tree shaken by a great wind. Right, then the kings of the earth, the nobles and the commanders, the rich, the mighty, and every slave and free man hid in caves and among the rocks of the mountains. Yeah, why would they do that? Because something's coming down from above. And they said to the mountains and the rocks, fall on us and hide us from the face of the one seated on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb. I mean, just think of it. I mean, really, just fucking think. What is it all about? It's all about an asteroid. An asteroid that's going to smash into the fucking earth. I mean, it doesn't get any simpler than fucking that, does it? I mean, really. 16, and they said to the mountains and the rocks, fall on us and hide us from the face of the one seated on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb. I mean, what happens when an asteroid comes and strikes the fucking earth? They break up and the stars, they fucking shooting stars come from everywhere. You've seen fucking the meteor showers and stuff. That's what's going to happen when an asteroid comes, because the asteroids break up in the atmosphere. And like I've covered in the last thing, they fucking glow all different colors of the rainbow, all different colors of the spectrum, burning up and losing bits and pieces and breaking apart before they actually hit. And when they do hit, right, and it's not just hit and bang and it's vaporized, it's hit and bounce and fucking, you know, land where they fucking may. Just watch the video before this one, all right, that I just covered all of that shit. So, I mean, for fuck's sake, and it's all about Jesus. Jesus will not meet thee as a man, will not be meeting you as a man. That's why he says, do not fucking, if they say Christ is here, do not go there or do not believe them. If Christ's out in the wilderness, do not believe them. If he's in the inner rooms or the inner courts, do not believe them. Because Jesus is not going to meet you as a man, but he's going to take vengeance. Vengeance. He's the angel, Michael, who's going to take vengeance on the earth. Because he's coming back to judge and make war. Make war with whom? With all the nations and the kingdoms. Right? Nations rising against nations and kingdoms rising against kingdoms. That's what he's coming to do. He's coming to put an end to that. For the elect's sake, the elect's sake, his chosen's sake, the people who is going to survive the incoming asteroid that is Apophis, for fuck's sake. Okay? So, what about all their bunkers and shit? You know, oh, you're going to be all right in bunkers and all that crap. Well, it's all been talked about. Amos 9:2. 9:2. Okay? Though they dig down to Sheol, from there my hand will take them. And though they climb up to heaven, from there I will pull them down. So it doesn't look like you got any place to hide. And why would that be? Because how could he pull you down from heaven or fucking take you out if you're dug in the fucking, you know, dug under the ground in hell or Sheol? And dug a hole for yourself. Well, these make pretty big holes, and they shake the fucking shit out of the land, and they cause all kinds of destruction, because they're, after all, you know, landing and creating a crater. And if a crater is that big, is gonna fucking change the outcome and the fucking, you know, way of the fucking world as it is, and create something new. I don't know what else is gonna create something new. So is it a crater or a creator that's going to smash into the fucking earth, i.e. Apophis. No, when? Oh, that's right, 30 AD, so 2,000 years after 30 AD is 2030. But Apophis comes when? 2029. I mean, for fuck's sake, people, the destruction of Israel. Yeah, Israel. Why are they going to have to fucking hide themselves? Hmm? Why are they going to have to hide themselves? Just take a think of all this shit. Okay? Obadiah. Let's see. Obadiah. 1:3. The pride of your heart has deceived you, O dwellers in the clefts of the rocks, whose habitation is in the heights, who say in your heart, who can bring me down to the ground? Though you soar like an eagle and make your nest among the stars, even from there I will bring you down, declares the Lord. Yeah, soar like an eagle, because they're all ill eagles. They're ill eagles, just like Rome. Yeah, Rome turned out to be an ill eagle and it fucking disappeared, destroyed itself, didn't it? And Germany, well, it turned out to be an ill eagle and it destroyed itself, didn't it? Just like America's an ill eagle and it's going to fucking destroy itself. How? Because God, yeah, rises and makes fucking civilizations fall. Yeah, that's the whole point of God, isn't it? And guess how God does it. And this is what he's going to do to Babylon, which is what I covered in the fucking first three parts of this fucking series, or whatever you want to fucking call it. Okay? So, just think of it all. It just makes absolute and utter fucking sense. It makes complete and utter fucking sense. I mean, it's all about the sun burning out in the end. Okay? So, this happens, and then it rains, the meek inherit the earth, for a certain period of time, which is where we have to fucking regain ourselves again because of the destruction of Apophis and what we see coming in the clouds, you know, in 2029, right? 2,000 years roughly after fucking, what? AD 30, which is when we're supposed to be waiting 2,000 years for fucking Jesus Christ to return. And, you know, 2,000 years just so happens to be, what, 2030. After fucking AD 30. I mean, really? And fucking Apophis, you think this isn't going to be used against us at all? You think, I reckon their whole plan is to fucking use this against us. The whole plan is this. I mean, this is what's happening. I've been seeing it for years and years. It's either God is fucking fulfilling the Bible or man is fulfilling the Bible and using it against all the fucking superstitious people out there. So whether you like it or not, you're going to have to fucking worry about all this shit, right? They're going to turn around and tell you they need weapons in space and shit to get rid of fucking stuff like this. I mean, you talk about aliens and fucking stuff like that, you know, and they're going to need to weaponize space for aliens. It's no, they're going to have to weaponize space for Apophis. They're going to tell you they need to weaponize space for Apophis. But just like it says, you know, you soar like an eagle and make your nest amongst the clouds or the stars, and from there I will bring you down, declares the Lord. You dig into hell or Sheol, I will fucking, my hand will be there, says the Lord. I mean, this has happened before, time's over. Just look at all the fucking ancient civilizations around the world and the fact that, you know, they've had the brains to fucking leave this symbolism and symbology around for people like me and other fucking, you know, people who actually know how to read fucking symbolism for what it is and point out the absolute brilliant science that was left behind in all these tales that is held against us by fucking idiots who claim to be scientists, for fuck's sake. I mean, stupid. It speaks for its fucking self. So the sun burns out, doesn't it? It heats up in the end. And this is what we're going to fucking have to wait for. And this is what we're told in science is going to happen. The sun's going to burn out. And all we're going to be left with is a fucking, what? A cold, dark fucking space. I mean, really? It's just going to be just ice. And that's what they call justice. And so we're going to have just ice left because there's going to be no sun. But the Bible says we don't need a sun and our sun's going to be God and fucking Jesus Christ. Right? So let's see. Isaiah 30, 26. okay? 30, 26. Okay. Moreover, the light of the moon shall be as the light of the sun, and the light of the sun shall be a sevenfold as the light of 7 days, in the day that the Lord bindeth up the breach of his people and healeth the stroke of their wound. Sevenfold, seven times greater than a sun. I've mentioned this in my lyrics and shit going back to fucking whatever, like 2000s and shit, 2001. You know, 2002, fucking, even before that. I can't even remember when I fucking wrote half the lyrics, but, you know, they were published fucking in 2005, I think, or something. But they fucking go back for fucking years and years. But I've written about this and shit, and sevenfold. Because this is what's going to happen. The sun's going to burn itself out. To burn itself out, it only gets hotter and hotter and hotter and hotter, and then it fucking implodes, basically, and goes out. Okay? So Isaiah 60:19-20. Okay? Isaiah 60:19. The sun shall be no more thy light by day, neither for brightness shall the moon give light unto thee. But the Lord shall be unto thee an everlasting light, and thy God thy glory. Alright? Make absolute sense to me, because that's what it tells us in Revelation. It repeats itself, for fuck's sake. The sun shall no more go down, neither shall thy moon withdraw itself, for the Lord shall be thine everlasting light, and the days of thy mourning shall be ended. When? When there's no sun and moon left, and all that's left is a sea like molten glass. When everything's burnt up and there's no water left, and the fucking, it's so hot that the fucking sand has even melted and turned into glass. So there's no longer a sea of people, there's just sand, because you're all as many as the sand of the sea, but the sand has already been melted and you've turned into molten glass. I mean, for fuck's sake. And what's going to happen, when does that happen? Obviously, just what I just read to you in Isaiah 30:26. Moreover, the light of the moon shall be as the light of the sun, and the light of the sun shall be sevenfold, as the light of the 7 days, in the day that the Lord bindeth up the breach of his people and healeth the stroke of their wound. Okay? So, let's see. Revelation 21, like I've fucking already shown you in prior videos, I'll go back to it, okay? Revelation 21, 22. 23. And the city has no need for the sun or moon to shine on it, because the glory of God illuminates the city, and the Lamb is its lamp. I mean, go down. The city had no need of the sun, neither of the moon, to shine in it, for the glory of God did lighten it, and the Lamb is the light thereof. All right? And 22:5. Revelation 22:5. I mean, you wonder how the book of Revelation was put together. And it's all telling you where to read the Old Testament. I mean, that's exactly what it is. Time's over. There shall be no light night there. They need no lamp nor light of the sun, for the Lord God gives them light. And they shall reign forever and ever. Right? And there shall be no night there, and they need no candle, neither light of the sun, for the Lord God giveth them light, and they shall reign for ever and ever. So there's New King James and the King James Version. Okay, so what is it all about? It's all about the end of the age in the south. That's what it's all about in the south, when the fucking sun burns out and God has his way. Yeah, and the cancer of the earth is obviously cleansed. Yeah, which is man, obviously. And, I mean, it's all about fucking, obviously, you know, the plume and the fucking Ayers rock. I mean, think of it. This is what Apophis is going to resemble. And Apophis is the most important thing that you people should be thinking about. Because this is what it's all about. It's like I fucking covered and told you in all the fucking past fucking shit. You know? Yeah, look into it all. I mean, just watch the fucking first three videos and tell me that it doesn't speak for itself. I mean, for some person that doesn't know symbology nor how to read their Bible, I'm sure it's confusing. But with people with brains and a heart for truth, you know, I mean, basically it's self-explanatory, all of this fucking shit, for fuck's sake. I mean, really? Okay? So obviously I'm going to have to fucking stop again. But, you know, you've been told basically all the same fucking shit. And I have to fucking, obviously, you know, probably make another fucking video in the future. So we'll see what happens. And until then, enjoy. War. World War fucking 3. You know, I've been talking about for fucking a long, long time in advance. For fuck's sake. I was telling everybody before 2012, before December 2012, when everyone's saying the world was going to fucking end, that this is what it was all about, and it was all about Apophis. Alright? I was telling people fucking 11, 12 years ago that it was all about Apophis. It had nothing to do with the Mayan calendar, etc., etc. And this is all fucking coinciding all at the same fucking time, for fuck's sake. This is all happening, you know, just like they fucking planned it to happen, because you're all a fucking lobster in the fucking cooking pot, you know, that's alive, you know, and instead of fucking chucking you in boiling hot water so you die fucking frantically and fucking, you know, painfully, they're turning the water up on you, they're turning the fucking heat up on you. And they're making you fucking go through this process to fucking get you all wrapped up in the wars and fucking rumors of wars that are going to go on, and nations rising against nations and kingdoms against kingdoms until 2029. 9 fucking years. And this is all going to accumulate fucking with Iran, Turkey, you know, because Turkey, World War One, World War Two, World War Three, Turkey. Turkey's always part of this shit, right? Turkey might as well be fucking Magog. Gog and Magog. Everyone says it's Russia. That's fucking bullshit. That's fucking Turkey, alright? And fucking, Iran, China, North Korea, fucking obviously. All of them are gonna coincide with each other. Syria, etc., etc. You got fucking Putin over there offering fucking Assad more help, knowing what's fucking going on, right? In the fucking Holy Land at the moment. What the fuck's all happening? I mean, for fuck's sake. This is all set up. It's all got to do with the debt. It's all got to do with Brexit and the debt and the fact that I told you long in advance too in all my Scorpio 1980 videos about Iran and about Brexit and about how fucking Brexit and fucking America and all this shit's going to accumulate to one point and they're going to use it all together on your fucking one time. Fucking, you know, debt with fucking America is going to come to the fucking its climax and Brexit's going to fucking happen. And, yeah, it's all going to be fucking against what? Yeah? Europe. It won't be United Europe anymore. It'll be fucking divided Europe because of all this shit and because of the ill eagle, you know, that fucking America, that fucking reigns under the eagle has become. For fuck's sake. It's just all a lead up to the fucking absolute theatre that they're playing on your asses in regards to the fact that they think you's fucking, you know, need to stay cotton wool wrapped, thinking that all's fucking well and everybody fucking cares about you, when nobody gives a fucking shit. I mean, have you seen the fuel prices going through the roof and shit? I told you it was all about, if you want a fucking, you know, thing to tell you when the fucking shit's gonna go down and stuff, watch the fuel prices. Over here, it's nearly $1.80 a fucking litre. Fucking for fuel. That's nearly gonna be $2 a fucking litre for fucking fuel over here. Fuck's sake, it's ridiculous. And meanwhile, what, there's fucking earthquakes and shit going on all around fucking, you know, Iran and fucking, what is it, Puerto Rico, right next door to Honduras and the fucking land bridge attaching South America to fucking North America. You know, the land bridge, it'll go under. And you all have to, if you're up in the Northern Hemisphere, get down to the Southern Hemisphere below the fucking equator. Like I've told you times over in the fucking past, because every time this shit happens, all this fucking crap goes down. And you can say it's fucking God, or you can also say it's fucking HAARP. And it's the technology that they have. I mean, fucking for all, you know, for all we know, and for all fucking it's worth, fucking America could be dropping fucking, you know, whatever fucking frequencies into the fucking earth and causing earthquakes around fucking Iran. I mean, fucking America could be dropping the frequencies. This is how they, you know, test for fucking oil and shit and resources are beneath the ground. It's been known for fucking years. They send vibrations, and those vibrations, a lot of the times, set off little earthquakes. And if they send the vibrations at a higher frequency, they can set off bigger fucking earthquakes. So, you know, and they're fucking, if you reckon, you know, it's a big deal and shit, and what, America's fucking so crazy, that they've got fucking all this weather control and HAARP technology. Well, what about fucking Iran and fucking Russia and China? You know, think they don't have the same technology? So if it's all gonna fucking hit the fucking roof and shit, and, you know, everyone's expecting this so-called war, fucking everyone expects war, how they've been programmed war is for the fucking past, you know, World War One and World War Two. But this one's gonna be completely fucking different. It's gonna be all fucking weather and laser technology, weather used as weapons. It's fucking gonna be absolute propaganda to its fullest, and fucking cyber warfare, and you know, everything. You just won't know what the fuck hits you. And this shit's going to be used against you, and it's just going to do your fucking heads in for 9 fucking years. For 9 years, and they're just going to fucking go at each other like fucking absolute crazy fucking dogfight, for fuck's sake, that you can't stop unless you get a bucket of water and throw it over and shock the fucking dogs into submission. I mean, that's what's going to fucking happen with Apophis. Because whether you like it or fucking not, Apophis is going to be held against you. Whether it's fucking God causing all this shit, and whether it's fucking man causing all this shit, this is what they're going to fucking use. Apophis. Apophis is what it's all about. And Apophis is fucking the end fucking game. You know, it's the end game. I've talked about all the aliens and how aliens are going to be used against us, and how fucking, you know, they've been breeding people in space for fucking a long time now. I mean, you think they don't breed people in space? And the people that are born in space look a whole lot different than us. So they're basically going to look like aliens anyway, because they haven't been brought up and fucking shit on gravity on Earth. So their looks are going to be a whole lot fucking different. Let alone the fact, you know, there are actual fucking aliens out there, and the Bible fucking proves that, because everything's symbolic and you have to look at it in 4 fucking ways. So what you take literally also has to be taken spiritually, physically, and orically. So you don't look at every fucking, you know, verse of the Bible as just one fucking way, but that's how they want you to fucking look at it. It's just one fucking way, one definition. They always want it to be literal for you, for fuck's sake. I mean, giants. Giants, it's all about the giant mentality, the mentality of the giants. Just like who built all these fucking massive, you know, temples and shit, like Baalbek and the Baalbek stones, and who fucking had the, you know, technology and the smarts to fucking, you know, build Egypt and the Egyptian pyramids, let alone fucking, you know, all these fucking massive, huge civilizations that are fucking, you know, known but rarely talked about and basically equated to fucking some ancient civilization like Atlantis, if not fucking aliens and fucking this and that. Everyone puts it down to giants, but the book of fucking, the lost books of the Bible and the forgotten books of Eden is fucking, equates those giants to the sons of Israel. And those sons of Israel had giant brains, and they used their brains, and they were looked at as giants. They were fucking giants in the eyes of the people because they were so fucking smart. And you'd have to be so smart to build those fucking things, let alone you'd have to be stupid not to fucking believe that, you know, we live with dinosaurs, and dinosaurs pulled all those massive stones and megaliths and fucking shit into place. Just like India does with elephants today on a smaller scale. Yeah, you think fucking a massive dinosaur couldn't basically, you know, pull a fucking Baalbek fucking, you know, stones into place? Tons and tons of material, and just drag it into fucking place, and all this shit, and everyone just says, oh, it must have been aliens, and, you know, all this crap. Well, we've been here before. Nothing's new under the fucking sun. You know, they know all this shit, and they hide it from you, and the knowledge is power, and, you know, they keep all the knowledge, and then they fucking spoon feed you with all this knowledge. This is fucking why half the people in the world think of World War One and World War Two is just gonna be fucking a bunch of idiots in fucking, you know, army suits and shit, carrying weapons and doing the same fucking shit as they did in World War One and World War Two, for World War Three. I mean, for fuck's sake, think about all this, because there's no fucking coincidence that fucking Brexit is happening this month, right? This month, January, all right? And all this stuff's hitting the fan this month with America and Iran because, you know, it's all about fucking money and pulling out of the fucking, you know, United Europe. It's not going to be United Europe anymore. And there's a big divide. There's the divide that I've been telling you about. The divide that happens, you know? We've got the cross and Jesus died for you on the cross, but then, just like Moses, but then Moses draws a line in the sand, you know? Moses fucking draws a line in the sand and says, everybody on my side, kill everybody on the other side. You know, Jesus comes and there's the cross and, you know, Moses puts the serpent up on the pole, up on the cross, and the serpent is there for everybody to bow down and get healed. But we're not in that time anymore, for fuck's sake. I mean, it's all about the kingdom of fucking God. And what? Babylon. So this is the kingdom of Babylon. This is the kingdom of God. You know, fucking the air. And what happens in the air? What is Babylon? Babylon's built up into the air. And, you know, God fucking brings down Babylon. Right? And the south is all about fucking, in reality, fucking God. I've covered this all before. It's so frustrating that I have to fucking do it all again. So, you know, Babylon has reigned for fucking thousands of years. And you've all, you know it. That's your fucking history. But Babylon has to come to an end. And it comes to an end in the West. Right? And the West brings, and the, what happens in the West, which brings Babylon to an end, brings in, you know, in the fucking meek inheriting the earth, only to rise up to the kingdom of God again, where fucking, it's not going to be fucking like Babylon, but it's going to be like the kingdom of God. And everyone's going to worry about what? Huh? About the fucking, end of days. Yeah, the end of days. When everything fucking hits the fucking shit. For fuck's sake. I mean, simply like fucking, what do you call it? For instance, the dragon, the Sacred Heart. It's all about the Sacred Heart, isn't it? Hey, oh, Sacred Heart this, Sacred Heart that. All right, Dio, Sacred Heart, live. Well, he gives it away, you know, without me having to go through all the scriptures and shit, because they're already 15 minutes into it. I want to go through other fucking shit. Dio gives it away at fucking 9:45. All right, 9:45 of this, okay? I mean, look for the Sacred Heart. The Sacred Heart. And where's the Sacred Heart? Where does Dio find the Sacred Heart? He finds the Sacred Heart in the dragon itself. Because there's the good dragon and there's the bad dragon, right? There's the good dragon and there's the bad dragon. There's the good serpent and there's the bad serpent. And Dio, everyone fights the coming of the fucking, Antichrist. Or whatever. Everyone's fucking fighting for the Antichrist. That's the bad dragon. And then everyone's fighting against God and the coming of God. And that's the good dragon. There's the good dragon and the bad dragon. And where you fucking least expect it, you find the Sacred Heart. So the dragon is fucking what? He goes to slay the dragon. He wants to slay the dragon. And he finds the Sacred Heart in the what? Huh? Hmm? Where does he find the Sacred Heart? Well, it just speaks for itself. Well, there's the Sacred Heart. Oh, it's inside the dragon. So which dragon are we talking about? We've got the Antichrist dragon, right, which is the beast. 100% is the beast. Okay? The Sacred Heart. For fuck's sake. So we've got the Antichrist dragon, and we've got fucking God. And they're mirrors of each other, just like we've got the fucking serpent that dies for you and the serpent that comes to destroy, right? And take vengeance for everybody that didn't listen, okay? Babylon's in the north, and the kingdom's in the fucking south. And Babylon's reigned for fucking thousands of years, and the fucking serpent, Apophis, is going to come in the sky and stop everything that's going to be happening between fucking now, 2020 and 2029, right? And in 2029, everyone's going to see Apophis coming in the sky, and they're not going to know whether it's going to strike the earth. I mean, you can say no one knows the time of the hour. Yeah, nobody knows the time of the hour, but they can know the season. They can know the fucking what it round about. Isn't that right? But no one knows the day nor the time nor the hour. Well, we all know that Apophis is going to fucking, come on the Friday the 13th, apparently, in 2029. But that's not going to strike then. It's going to fucking go past the Earth and then come back 7 years later. And they don't know the day, they don't know the time, and they don't know the hour. And nobody knows that exactly anyway. They can make a little prediction of it, but that's just like the weather. That prediction can be fucking off. So nobody knows the day, nor the time, nor the hour. But we all know that Apophis is going to be seen in the sky between the Earth and the fucking Earth satellites, all the satellites that we have up in the sky, in 2029, apparently fucking what? And AD 30 and AD 33 is fucking what? 2,000 years after that date, we're supposed to expect Jesus Christ's second coming. And it's all about the scroll. What is it? This is all about the fucking scroll being fucking in the sky. Like the sky dividing like a fucking scroll. So, let's see. Okay, Isaiah 34:4. Isaiah 34:4. Yeah, Bible Hub. The stars of heaven will be dissolved. Oh, where is it? And all the hosts of heaven shall be dissolved. The heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll. And all their hosts shall fall down as the leaf falleth off the vine and as the falling fig from the fig tree. I mean, and that's what's going to fucking happen. I mean, that's what we're all expecting to happen. Yeah? That's what it's all about. That's fucking what happens after the tribulation, after Jacob's trouble. Jacob's trouble is the wars. Jacob is Israel, right? Israel, fucking, and I've gone over whom Israel actually is. You all believe and fucking worship in apostate Israel, which is fucking Israel as you know it today. Right? But it's all about that and the tribulation of Jacob and the fucking tribulation that's fucking going on now. And this is what's going to happen. I mean, a scroll rolled together like a scroll. What can make that fucking, make the sky appear like it's fucking, shall be rolled together as a scroll? I mean, a fucking asteroid. An asteroid is the only thing that can make it look like that. Because when a scroll rolls together, it's fucking what? It's coming together like this. And then there's a fucking divide. There's a divide. It's like a book. I don't have a fucking book in front of me, but it's like a fucking open book. And there's the fucking, and it rolls and fucking, the sides fucking come to one. And it looks like a fucking asteroid. I mean, I've gone over all of this and I've explained it better in fucking other videos and shit. Just fucking think about it all. I mean, for fuck's sake. So this is what it's all about. And this is Isaiah. Isaiah telling you, yet again, just like the fucking book of Revelation is, a fucking montage of the Old Testament, telling you fucking, this is where the fucking Revelation is telling you to look. Isaiah 34:4. When in the book of what? Revelation 6:14. Alright, Revelation 6:14. How frustrating it is, having to explain all this shit. And heaven departed as a scroll when it is rolled together, and every mountain and island were moved out of their places. Every mountain and island were moved out of their places. Right? Because it's all about the four fucking winds of the earth, the four pillars of the earth. Right? The four fucking horsemen. And the north, south, east, and west. Fucking Ezekiel's wheels. Ezekiel's wheels. There was a man, or a cherub, or a man. A lion, an eagle, and an ox. I mean, the man or the cherub, the angel, the man or the cherub, a lion, an eagle, and an ox. All right? Ezekiel's fucking wheels. Everyone goes, oh, Ezekiel's wheels is all about aliens. Oh, it's all about fucking aliens. Oh, wow. The aliens. But, this is fucking Revelation. And clearly telling you that you have to fucking, to understand what it's talking about in the book of Revelation 6:14, which is the revelation of Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ is the Word of God, obviously. And the Word of God is the Bible. So the book of Revelation is a montage of fucking telling you where to look in the Old Testament to know what's going on. And it's telling you to look in Isaiah 34, chapter fucking 34, verse 4. Right? And this is all about fucking, what, go 14, 15, the terror. Oh, the terror. Go 14, 15, and the kings of the earth and the great men and the rich men and the chief captains and the mighty men and every bondman and every free man hid themselves in the dens and in the rocks of the mountains. From what? From the coming of the Son of Man. Yeah. From the coming of the Son of Man. They hid themselves in the fucking mountains and in the rocks. In the clefts of the fucking rocks. 16. Alright? And said to the mountains and rocks, fall on us and hide us from the face of him that sitteth on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb. No, the wrath of the fucking Lamb. Why? Huh? Why is that? Huh? We've already been over it all. Because of Isaiah. Isaiah, just like I pointed out, Isaiah 34:4. Okay? And all the host of heaven shall be dissolved, and the heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll, and all their hosts shall fall down as the leaf falleth off from the vine and from the falling fig from the fig tree. And it's all about Edom. Edom, the judgment on the nations, because the nations are fighting against each other, man, wars and rumors of wars, kingdom against kingdom, nation against nation. For my sword shall be bathed in heaven. Behold, it shall come down upon Edomia and upon the people of my curse to judgment. Upon Edom. Upon Edom. Right? Edom. Okay? It's all about Edom, and you are Edom. And you all worship Edom and the Edomites because of the fake Israel that you fucking follow, which is fucking Israel as you know it today, which was actually always Judah. Yeah, Judah. Israel actually is Aram. Aram, which is Syria. Right? Syria and Aram. And you have been fucking taken out God's Israel, the apple of God's eye now, for fucking years. And what's happening to Syria for all these fucking years now is what you're going to witness now happen to fucking Israel as you fucking know it. Up until 2029, right? Including fucking Turkey and fucking, you know, Russia and China and America and fucking you name it. All fucking America's allies, all thinking and trying to get you into this fucking big stupid thing. And the God's judgment on the nations for doing this and coming against fucking Syria and coming against Judah, etc., etc., is going to all accumulate to fucking the scroll. Yeah? To the scroll of fucking Revelation, chapter 6, verse 14, and Isaiah 34:4, right? Stars of heaven will be dissolved, the skies will be rolled up like a scroll. And that's fucking Apophis, which is coming in 2029, okay? Friday the 13th, between fucking the world and the satellites that we have put up into the sky. For fuck's sake. But instead, you know, you'd love to fucking sit there, and oh, you do love to fucking sit there. So look up Dio, Sacred Heart, yeah, and look at fucking, what, at 9:45, all right? And just see what he's talking about. He's implying and pointing to the two dragons, God the dragon and Babylon the dragon, the Antichrist and the Christ. And Jesus Christ is basically anti of himself anyway. Because he comes to save you, then he comes to kill everybody that never listened to him when he first come to fucking save you. He come to fucking die for your sins, and he's going to kill you for your sins if you fucking didn't listen to him and learn. I mean, fuck's sake.